Meanwhile, the U.S. envoy for Afghanistan, Zarmeh Khalilzad, is in Qatar for high-level meetings on the ongoing political crisis and the turmoil in Afghanistan. A multilateral meeting on the peace process was held in Doha. It was attended by Khalilzad along with attendees from the United Nations, China, UK, Pakistan, Uzbekistan and the European Union. The participating parties called for a political settlement to achieve enduring peace. All representatives agreed that a political solution through negotiation is the only way out for Afghanistan. Later today, the Troika meet involving the US, China, Russia, also Pakistan will be held. India, Indonesia and Turkey will also participate in a regional conference on Afghanistan situation in Doha on Thursday. Meanwhile, U.S. President Joe Biden has defended his decision to pull out the troops from Afghanistan. The comments were made at the White House at a time when the security situation is rapidly worsening and the number of casualties rising. The president also said that the U.S. will be keeping its commitment to provide air support, but Afghan leaders must come together and fight for themselves.
No. Look. We spent over $1 trillion, over 20 years. We trained and equipped with modern equipment over 300,000 Afghan forces. And Afghan leaders have to come together. We lost thousands, lost death and injury, thousands of American personnel. They've got to fight for themselves, fight for their nation. The United States, I'll insist we continue to keep the commitments we made of providing close air support, making sure that their Air Force functions and is operable, resupplying their forces with food and equipment, and paying all their salaries. But we're going to continue to keep our commitment. But I do not regret my decision.
The advisor to the Afghan National Security Council, Javed Faisal, has said that peace is the Afghan government's top priority. As the Taliban continue with the offensive, the Afghan Security Council has vowed to not just recapture its territory, but also to protect its citizens.
You cannot negotiate with someone who does not believe in negotiations. They just believe in one thing, war, war, and war. And what war brings? Death, destruction, failure. And it kills the prospects for peace. So that's why we are calling on the Taliban and their advisors, the countries behind them, to come to the peace talks.
Our principal diplomatic correspondent, Siddhant Sibyl, is now joining us on the broadcast with more details. Siddhant, while we have been tracking those talks very closely, the optimism regarding their outcome has been fizzling. Given the sharp contrast between the commitment made during those talks and the escalating violence on the ground.
Well, yes, on the ground, situation is vastly deteriorating by each passing minute. In fact, Taliban is making rapid territorial gains, and it looks like Taliban can be on the gates of Kabul, the national capital, in a matter of a few weeks. But nonetheless, there are talks happening. Doha, of course, is the center of talks, whether it's the Troika talks or whether it's the Afghanistan regional meeting in which India has been invited. In fact, the Qatari special envoy was in India last week, and he had talks with Indian External Affairs Minister Dr. S. Jayashankar, the Foreign Secretary Harsh Shringla, and the JSPI J.P. Singh. And during the talks, he talked about the situation and extended the invite. But will talks yield to anything constructive on the ground is something that many will not be very hopeful for, given that how Taliban has been emboldened by the recent gains on the ground. There are, in fact, right now two Talibans. The Taliban sitting in Doha, much more sophisticated Taliban, which has been coming out with press releases. But on the ground, it is a very different Taliban. In fact, just in last few hours, we have spoken to Atta Noor, who is a top Afghan leader in northern Afghanistan. He's a Tajik and of course holds sway in the Balkh province, whose capital is Mazar-e-Sharif, which of course is looking towards not only encirclement but a larger battle as well. We also spoke to his son Khalid Noor. Both talked about the current situation. They talked about how they will defend the city till the last breath, whether it's fighting on the streets or making sure that the right of their people, they said that they are not going to abandon their people. Well, there is strong will when it comes to the Afghan political leadership, the people on the ground, but it looks like the offensive by Taliban, the counter offensive by the Afghan government, humanitarian crisis that is erupting in Afghanistan. The territories which are now under Taliban control have seen visuals, heartbreaking visuals of children and women who are getting impacted by this current perhaps a start of a civil war. The big, of course, positive outcome could have been power sharing agreement between Taliban and the Afghan government, but it looks like Taliban is least interested about any kind of power sharing. They want all the power, and that is the outcome on the ground. A complete bloodshed, it looks like Afghanistan is heading towards.
Right, and we will be monitoring those developments very closely. Siddhant, thanks very much for those updates for now. We are now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.